Hi guys, my name is Kevin.
I'm Haido.
I'm Andres.
And today we're here in Amping because we are going to explore Amping. We're going to the Amping Treehouse. We're going to go to the fortress, and we're going to learn a little bit about its history, about its interesting places. So let's go.
Actually, a lady at the front told me that this is not like a common tree house. Mm-hmm. Those are actually first a house and then a tree grew out of it.
Oh, wow, that's really interesting.
Yeah. And after World War II, it was actually built, well, the intention for the warehouse was that it was for the Taiwan's main salt company, mm-hmm. the Taiwan Salt Corporation.
Oh, okay. But did you know why the trees are like this?
No.
Well, it's because the banyan tree thrives in humid areas, and we all know how Taiwan is very humid. Mm-hmm. So the trees are like this.
Cool.
Find ourselves right now in a Tay and Company merchant house that it was built in 1867 by a British entrepreneur that is called James Tait. He's actually a businessman interested in the business of tea, in banking and insurance. In general, the Westerners adopted this arcade style building in Taiwan to cope with the heat and the rain. Later on, actually, this building became an important element in the architecture, being this building, actually the Tait and Company Merchant House, as a really good example.
As we walk out of the Tait and Company Merchant House, we move forward to the Zhu Jioying residence. He was born in Shangsha County, Hunan Province in 1898. After the government office was relocated to Taiwan, Zhu took charge of the Taiwan Salt Corporation. Besides relentlessly pursuing his works and studies, Zhu loved calligraphy and had a vast collection of calligraphic works. He practiced calligraphy daily and wrote an introduction to calligraphy to encourage the learning of it.
So we have just visited the Amping Treehouse, and we have learned a lot of new things about Tainan's history.
Now we're heading to our second and last destination, which should be the Amping Gold Fort, also known as Fort Selandia here in Tainan.
Let's go! So we're already here in the Fort Selandia, but actually before going inside, we want to talk about a very important architectural thing that is behind us. Can you talk about it a little bit?
So you guys can see the wall. It was actually called the sweet wall because it was made with very special ingredients such as oyster shells, syrup and glutinous rice. The oyster shells contained calcium carbonate, which keeps the ants away, because this was known as the sweet wall, so obviously it's going to attract ants.
We are heading now to Fort Selandia, a fortress built over 10 years from 1624 to 1634 by the Dutch East India Company. In that time, when Europeans from many countries sailed to Asia to develop trade, Taiwan became one of East Asia's most important transit sites, and Fort Selandia an international business center. As trade at that time depended on military force to control the markets, the value of the fortress was mainly in its strategic position.
Well, thank you so much, guys, for joining us in this adventure. It's been quite interesting and fun to learn about the old history of China. So, yeah, thanks again for joining us, and see you next time.
Thanks, guys. You should totally come here.
Uh-huh. Bye.
Bye-bye.